Hello, my dear class 11th students. Welcome you all to my YouTube channel, my dear students. Today we will do the remaining questions of the exercise 3. I could not complete that exercise in the last video, so today we will try to complete this exercise 3, which is based on angles and arc lengths. So I do question number 8. Question says, the moon's distance from the earth is, sorry, 8 we did in the last video. We need to go to question number 9. A railway train is traveling on a curve. A railway train is traveling on a curve of 750 meter radius at the rate of 30 km per hour. Radius is 750 meter, and the train is moving on this curved path at the speed of 30 km/h. Speed given, not the distance. Through what angle has it turned in 10 seconds? Time given. We have to calculate the angle subtended at the center by this arc theta. Theta equals to L by R. I hope you remember. Theta equals to L by R. So when you use this formula, theta equals to L by R, theta will come in radian. Keep it in mind, in radian. So let us calculate the length of this arc L. To calculate this distance, to calculate this length of the arc L, to length L, to calculate the length L of this arc, we need to use the formula distance equal to speed into time. But you can see distance can be calculated when the speed and time are expressed in the proper unit. Speed is in kilometer per hour and time is in second. How can we get the distance covered, which will be actually the length of the arc? First we need to change, this to meter per second. So I am going to change the speed to meter per second. 30 kilometer per hour. I hope you know, you might have studied in class 7 or 8. And a speed in kilometer per hour can be changed to meter per second when we multiply the value of the speed in kilometer per hour by 5/18. So this is 30 kilometer per hour, I multiply it by 5/18, then I will get the speed in meter per second. 6 × 5 = 30, 6 × 3 = 18, 25/3 meter per second. Now I will be using speed into time to get the distance, which will actually be length of the arc. So I write here, length of arc L equals to distance covered in 10 seconds, speed into time 25 upon 3 into 10, 250 upon 3 meter. 250 upon 3 meter. So, this is the length of the arc and its symbol is L. So, we have R, we have L, we can have the theta, okay. So, theta equals to L 250 upon 3 upon 750. So, 250 upon 3 into 1 upon 750, 25, 3 ja 75. So, we get 1 upon 9 radian. This is the angle subtended by this arc. I mean, it was asked how much angle will be subtended at the center when train moves with the speed of 30 km per hour for 10 seconds. So, in 10 seconds, the distance what the train covers, that distance will actually subtend an angle of 1 upon 9 radian at the center. Let's go to the next question. Question number 10. A horse is tethered to a stake by a rope 810 centimeter long. Horse is moving along this cord path. So, length of this string is, rope is 810 centimeter. So, length of the rope is actually equal to the radius of this sector. Now, what the next information says? If the horse moves along the circumference of a circle always keeping the rope tight, how far it will have gone when the rope has traced out an angle of 70 degree. So, when this angle is 70 degree, we need to calculate the length of the arc, which is actually the distance covered by the horse. घोड़ा 70 डिग्री, घोड़ा इस रास्ते पर कितना दूर चलेगा अगर रस्सी हमेशा टाइट रहती है और एंगल बनता है 70 डिग्री का. सो रिमेंबर व्हेन यू यूज द फार्मूला एल इक्वल्स टू आर थीटा टू कैलकुलेट दिस लेंथ, थीटा मस्ट बी एक्सप्रेस्ड इन रेडियन. रिमेंबर while this theta is given in degree, so we need to change this into radian. To change this 70 degree to radian, we need to multiply this value by pi upon 180. So, theta which is 70 degree should be converted to radian. So, 70 into pi upon 180. So, 7 pi upon 180 radian, okay. So, theta we have, R we have, L we can have. So, L equals to R theta, 810 into 7 into pi upon 18, 9 2 ja 18, 9 9 ja 81, 2. 45. So let us simplify this. 45 into 7 into 22 by 7. 7, 7 cancel. 45 to 90, carry 9. 990 centimeter. If this is in centimeter, so this length will come in centimeter. Let me see. Centimeter given? Yes. So question number 10. 990 centimeter will be the distance covered by the horse. So this L is the distance covered by the horse. Question number 11. The area of a sector is 5.024 centimeter square. Area of the sector is 5.024 centimeter square and its angle is 36 degree. Here theta is 36 degree. What we have to find? Find the radius given that pi is 3.14. I told you that to use the formula for area half LR or half R square theta, the angle theta must be in radian, must be in radian. So area of the sector is half R square theta. Half r square theta. So this theta I am going to change into radian. 36 into pi upon 180 radian. 18 10 ja, 18 2 ja, 2 5 ja. So we get the angle theta as pi upon 5 radians. Okay, so put here 1 upon 2 r square into pi upon 5 equals to 5.024 centimeter square. So R square equals to 5.024 into, do the cross multiplication, into 5 upon into 2, 2 into 5, we need to do multiplication, upon 3.14. So we get here 50.24, 5 to the 10. When we multiply by 5.024, we will get 50.24 upon 3.14. It will be 16. So R square is 16. So the value of R will be square root 16. So we get the radius as 4 centimeter. Next question. Question number 12. We have area of a sector is, sorry, it was 11. Now question number 12. Find the area of the sector given that radius is 5 meter and length of the arc is 8 meter. Radius 5 meter, L 8 meter, and we want to find area of the sector. area is half LR also. Half LR also. So half into 8 into 5. 20 meter square. 20 meter square. Next. So remember my dear students, area of a sector can be calculated by three formulas. I write here, first one half LR, second one half R square theta, third one pi R square into theta upon 360. Here the theta is central angle but measured in degrees. Here theta is central angle but measured in radian. Keep it in mind. This theta must be measured in radian, and here theta should be in degrees. So these are the three formulas to calculate the area of a sector. Question number 13. What we have? The diagram shows a windscreen wiper cleaning a car. Okay, कार की खिड़की को साफ करने वाला वाइपर. डायग्राम प्लीज सी. वी हैव अ रेक्टेंगल. अ सेक्टर. वी हैव with its central angle 8 pi upon 9 radian. Radius is 45 centimeter and the length is 100 centimeter. Width is 55 centimeter. This radius of this sector is 45 centimeter. What we have to calculate? What is the length of the arc swept out? This length we want to calculate in the first part. Length of arc swept out is equal to r into theta. R is 45 and theta is 8 pi by 9. 40 pi. You can put the value of pi, 3.14. So we get 125.60 centimeter. Next, what area of the windscreen is not cleaned? we want to get the area of this portion which is not cleaned. To get the area of this shaded portion, we need to subtract the area of the sector from the area of the rectangle. I hope you remember, area of the rectangle is L into B and area of the sector is half LR, half LR. I have written here. So, let's get area of sector half LR. So, half, I put this one, 40 pi into R, 45. So 900 pi. So 900 into 3.14 0 0, 9 4 जा 36, 9 1 जा 9 3 12, कैरी 1, 9 3 जा 27, 28, 2826.00. This is the area of the sector. Area uncleaned, area of rectangle minus area of sector. So, area of rectangle is length into breadth, 100 into 55 minus 2826. Minus 2826. 10 minus 6, 4, 9 minus 2, 7, 17 minus 8, 14 minus 8, 6, 4 minus 2, 2, 2, 6, 7, 4. Let me check again, half LR, I think. If I, let me do, answer is not matching. Half LR, L is according to me here, L is 125.6, which is rounded off and given that 126 centimeter, but I used L as 40 pi. So half LR, 45 2 90, 9 4 ja 36, 9 1 ja 9 3 12, carry 1, 28 26, 10 minus 6 4, 9 minus 2 7, 14 minus 8 6, 4 minus 2 2. So, if I use 40 pi, the area which is not unclean is 2674. But when I use this as the area of, length of the arc, let us see what the answer comes. I am saying this is my answer and which is correct, but I want to check whether what I get when I use this, since in the book at the place of 125.60 and here it is not said that round it off. When we are not said to round it off, how can we take the area as 3126? So, if I take instead of this value here for L, I want to cross check whether in that case the answer given in the book tallies with this or not. Or half L is 126, R is 45, 2 6 = 12, 2 3 = 6, 63 × 45, 5 3 = 15, 5 6 = 30, 31, 4 3 = 12, 4 6 = 24, 25, 5 2 1 3, 5 3 8, 2 8 3 5. When I use 126, 2 8 3 5, I get the area. So 5500 minus 2 8 3 5, 10 minus 5 5, 9 minus 3 6, 14 minus 8 6, 4 2 6 6 5. Again answer is not matching. Let us use this value, 125.6. So I think my answer is correct, it is not wrong. So you can use 2674. To get the answer what is given in the book, मैं तीसरी बार जा रहा हूँ क्रॉस चेक करने कि अब इसको चेक कर लिया जाए कि बुक के आंसर से टैली करता है कि नहीं. 5 6 = 30, 5 5 = 25, 3 28, 5 2 = 10, 2 12, 5 1 = 5, 6, 4 6 = 24, carry 2, 4 5 = 20, 22, 4 2 = 8, 2 10, 4 1 = 41, 5 0, 8 4 = 12, 2 2 = 41, 5, 7 आ रहा है, 5 7 5 2 अपॉन 2. सो इसकी वैल्यू आ रही है 2 2 = 4, 2 8 = 16, 2 7 = 14, 2 6 = 2 8 7 6. अब इसको माइनस करके देखते हैं, 5 5 0 0, 2 8 7 6, 10 - 6 = 4. फिर से चेक करता हूँ, 5 6 5 2. So 2 2 = 4, 2 8 = 16, 2 2 = 4, 10 - 6 = 4, 9 - 2 = 7, 14 - 8 = 6, 2 6 = 7 = 4. सो किसी भी तरीके से मैंने क्रॉस चेक किया, आंसर बुक में जो दिया है वो मैच नहीं कर रहा. सो आपको चिंता करने की जरूरत नहीं है, जो मैंने आंसर दिया वो आई थिंक इट इज़ करेक्ट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 14. फाइंड द एरिया ऑफ द शेडेड सेगमेंट. We have a sector, this is sector, this is segment. To get the area of this segment, we will subtract the area of this triangle which is equilateral from the area of the sector. Area of segment is equal to area of sector minus area of triangle, which is equilateral. You know how I am saying equilateral? Because this is an isosceles triangle with its vertical angle 60 degree. This is an isosceles triangle because its two sides are equal, and this is the vertical angle 60 degree. So these two base angles will also be 60 degree. So we can say that this triangle is equilateral triangle. So from the area of the sector, when we subtract the area of the equilateral triangle, we will get the area of the segment. ठीक, स्पष्ट हुआ? अब इसको आप चाहें तो आप जो क्लास टेंथ में फार्मूला शायद पढ़े होंगे या नहीं पढ़े होंगे, कोई बात नहीं, एरिया ऑफ द सेक्टर का फार्मूला टेंथ में पढ़ाया जाता है पाई आर स्क्वायर इंटू थीटा बाई 360, जो कि थीटा डिग्री में होता है. अभी हम लोग जो हाफ एल आर हाफ आर स्क्वायर थीटा पढ़ रहे हैं, थीटा इज इक्वल टू एल बाई आर पढ़ रहे हैं, इसमें जो थीटा है वो रेडियन में. चलिए रेडियन से ही कर लेते हैं. पहले इस ट्राइंगल की एरिया, अब एरिया ऑफ द ट्राइंगल, रेडियस कितना दिया है 24 सेंटीमीटर. आप यहां ब्रैकेट में लिख लीजिए इक्विलेटरल रूट 3/4 इंटू साइड स्क्वायर फोर सिक्स जा 24, सिक्स फोर जा 40, सिक्स फोर जा 24, सिक्स टू जा 12, 144 रूट 3 एरिया ऑफ द सेक्टर. हाफ आर स्क्वायर थीटा आर इज 24 एंड थीटा मस्ट बी हियर इन रेडियन. लेट अस चेंज 60 इंटू पाई बाई 180, 63 जा 180, 38 जा 24, 24 जा 8, सो वी गेट 24 इंटू 24 96 पाई. दिस इज एरिया ऑफ सेक्टर. From this area, when we subtract this, we will get the area of the segment, this one. Do we have any suggestion for pi? No. Let's take 3.14. Area of segment is equal to area of sector minus area of equilateral triangle 96 into 3.14 minus 144 into root 3, 1.732. Ninety-six into three point one four. Then 9 4 जा 36, 9 1 जा 9 3 12, 9 3 जा 27 28, 4 14 11 0 3. 144 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1.732 4 2 8 4 3 12 4 7 28 29 4 1 42 6 8 2 9 6 2 3 7 1 8 10 9 2 11 11 2 13 1 14 7 3 10 9 19 1 carry 7 7 14 2 decimal after 3 place 301.44 minus 249.408 10 minus 8 2 3 0 11 minus 9 2 9 minus 4 5 52.2 centimeter square it's given. So question, in the question, in the solution, I use the value of pi 3.14. You can check the answer by keeping the value 22/7. Actually, when in the question the value of pi is not mentioned, we take it as 22/7. If it is mentioned to take 3.14, then only. So my answer is, there is slight difference, so not much difference. So it is 52.03 and here it is given 52.2, so not much difference. So I write it as answer instead of what I put here. No, the value of pi I put 3.14, you could have put 22/7 and check, maybe it is, maybe you get the answer as 52.2. कोई बात नहीं, मेरा ये आंसर आया, आप पाई की वैल्यू 22/7 रख के चेक कर लीजिए, शायद आपका आंसर आ जाए. बट द कॉन्सेप्ट रिमेन्स सेम. माई वीडियो इज फॉर एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट. न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू यू कैन डू इट विथ कैलकुलेटर ऑल्सो एंड चेक. नेक्स्ट इज 15. What is the ratio of the areas of the major sector in the diagram A to the minor sector in the diagram B? And this is the last question of the exercise. Question 14 के लिए मैंने क्या suggestion दिया? Question 14 के लिए suggestion दिया कि आप pi की value 22/7 लेकर के question को solve करिए, शायद आपका answer book के answer से tally कर जाए. Question 15. What is the ratio of the areas of the major sector in the diagram A to the minor sector in the diagram B? I hope आपको major sector और minor sector का idea होगा. नहीं है तो अभी explain कर देता हूँ. यह है minor sector. यह है मेजर सेक्टर. मेजर सेक्टर उस सर्कल के उस सेक्टर को बोलते हैं जिसका सेंट्रल एंगल 180 डिग्री से ज़्यादा हो जाता है. जब सेंट्रल एंगल 180 डिग्री से ज़्यादा होता है तो उस सेक्टर को मेजर सेक्टर कहते हैं. जब सेंट्रल एंगल 180 डिग्री होता है या पाई रेडियन होता है तो उस केस में उस सेक्टर को सेमी सर्किल कहते हैं, अदरवाइज माइनर सेक्टर कहते हैं जब वो 180 डिग्री या पाई रेडियन से कम होता है. तो ये आपका मेजर सेक्टर ए है, ये माइनर सेक्टर बी है. सेंट्रल एंगल आप देख सकते हो डिग्री में दिया है, यहाँ पे 150 डिग्री दिया है. तो ये एंगल हमको चाहिए, तो 360 से माइनस कर दीजिए, 210 डिग्री. ठीक। अब हमको चाहिए क्या, रेशियो ऑफ द एरियाज, चलिए इस बार सीधे फार्मूला रखते हैं, हाफ एरियाज ना आर स्क्वायर थीटा, दोनों का रेडियस सेम है, आर ही सिंबल दिया हुआ है, आर स्क्वायर थीटा, थीटा क्या है 210 इंटू पाई बाई 180, थीटा को बदलना पड़ेगा ना रेडियन में, यहाँ आइए हाफ आर स्क्वायर 60 इंटू पाई बाई 180, पाई बाई 180, पाई बाई 180 कट गया, हाफ आर स्क्वायर, हाफ आर स्क्वायर कट गया, जीरो से जीरो कट गया, 37 जा 21, 32 जा 6, सो वी विल गेट द रेशियो एज 7:2। सो आई हैव फिनिश्ड, आई हैव डन एवरी क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज इज दिस चैप्टर माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स। इन सम ऑफ द आंसर्स, द आंसर वट आई कैलकुलेटेड इज नॉट मैचिंग, सो यू can do and check by putting the value of pi instead of 3.14, 22/7. If the answer tallies, then you go for that method. Otherwise, the concept what I explained, I hope is clear to you. So, meet you in the next video with the next chapter, the chapter what you want. You can suggest me, you can write it in the comment box. Don't forget to like, subscribe and share the channel. Bye bye.